We should make no mistake. Without concerted actions, the next generation will be roasted, toasted, fried, and grilled.
I refuse to condemn your generation and future generations to a planet that's beyond fixing.
We must do far more to help the poorest and most vulnerable members of society who are suffering most from climate impact.
Words. So many big words. See, there's a lot of talk about climate change right now, but what are people actually doing about it? What are you actually doing about it? We see there's some that are trying to kick the big polluters in the place where it hurts the most. Their wallets. In their wallets.
The fossil fuel divestment movement is basically climate change activists who used to chain themselves to trees and trucks, now seeking out the banks and investment funds that fund oil, gas and the coal industries, pressuring them to pull out of their investments in carbon-emitting projects. Projects like the 9 planned coal mines in Queensland's Galilee Basin, which would not only create some of the biggest coal mines in Australia, but according to divestment activist 350.org, would be the 7th largest source of carbon emissions in the world. Divestment campaigns aren't new, but they have worked in the past. Pressure campaigns saw $3.5 billion worth of oil exploration in Sudan divested or frozen. 30-odd years of campaigning saw an estimated $5 billion divested from big tobacco firms. And throughout the 80s, 2.3 billion rand of capital outflow divested, helping draw attention to apartheid in South Africa. Still, it's hard to shake the image of investment bankers and fund managers giving a toss about where the money's going, as long as it's going into their pockets. But, astonishingly, there are some.
We invest other people's money. We've never invested in coal.
Dr. Stuart Palmer is the head of ethics at an investment fund. Yeah, I know. I had to read that twice too. He says some investors believe that if they don't get out of coal fast, they'll be stranded with stocks they can't sell.
It's built an enormous amount of momentum from universities, not-for-profits, individuals divesting.
The big four banks have lent $36.7 billion to Australian coal, oil and gas projects since 2008. In fact, since then, $134.3 billion was lent to Australia's fossil fuel industry by 150 commercial banks. But when it comes to renewable energy investment, the big four are a little shy. For every dollar loaned to the renewable energy industry since 2008, the big four banks lent nearly $6 to fossil fuels. Australians collectively have about $2 trillion in superannuation savings, and what you can invest in or divest in is up to you.
Most people will think about where the coffee I buy, the jeans I buy, you know, is it fair trade? It's a question that can be asked in relation to super and should be asked, we think. I mean, it's the biggest lump of money that most of us are going to have in our lifetime.
You can find out if your super fund is clean or dirty at sites like superswitch.org.au. It could be the new democracy. When governments don't do what we want, investors vote with their shares.